Hey, Clayton Bates here, and in today's video, I'm going to walk you through exactly what the school platform is and how to build a school group for yourself. Now, you might be wondering, what is school? And I'm going to go through that right now. So, school is a platform built by Sam Ovens, and now Alex Hormozi is invested in the platform. Basically, it's a community where you can have an online program. People can interact with each other, similar to a Facebook group, and you can give your community awards and things like that. It really brings people together without the distraction of Facebook. One of the reasons I'm making this video on this channel also is that in my agency, my Shopify agency, we've helped 600 people, and some of the most successful people have actually sold a product and then had a back-end course on it. So some of our clients making millions of dollars will break even on their product and then have back-end programs where they make millions of dollars selling courses and stuff. So I thought this might be a good way to put your Shopify store together with a community and have something awesome. Or if you have an agency or you want to teach people how to play guitar, for example, you can do that in this community. So let's dive into my computer and go through everything right now. So first of all, if you do want to start a community, there's a link below. It's an affiliate link. If you use my link, I'm going to give you a free gift. Just send me a message and I'll send that over to you. No dramas at all. But basically, my way of saying thank you. You'll come to a page here where you can start your community and add your payment details and stuff like that. School is $99 a month USD with a 14-day free trial. If you don't want to start a community, you can just go to school.com, skoll.com, and create an account where you don't have a community. You can actually join communities. So basically, back to my community here. So this is what it looks like inside a community. So basically, we have this community tab here where people can come here and write posts and stuff like that and interact with each other. So, for example, we have this welcome post where it says, "Welcome, introduce yourself," and it's pinned at the top. Basically, where people introduce themselves and 200 comments on this, where basically they go in, "Hey, I'm from here, such and such," everything like that. And then there's other like comments and stuff all through here. There's hundreds of them, sort of thing. So, if you've got any questions or anything like that, you can come to the community and ask a question or interact with other people. I really like this feature because sometimes when you're learning something, just watching a program or a YouTube video or something like that, you can't really interact and ask questions. So if you actually ask a question here when you watch some of the content and stuff like that, other people are like giving you their thoughts, their opinions, what they went through. The owner of the group is doing stuff like that. I think that's a really good way to learn. Then we have this here where it says classroom. So basically, you can come here and what you can have programs and stuff like that. Personally, what I've started to do with mine, where I teach agency owners how to scale and stuff like that, is I have a classroom here where it's like start here. And then if you click into here, it has everything about school and stuff. So it has like quick intro into school. So it just tells you a rundown of school, how to introduce yourself. The good thing about these classrooms is that you can actually pin threads from the community in here. So if you actually scroll down here, this is actually the post for introduce yourself. So what we just seen a second ago. So this introduce yourself is actually pinned to that classroom, which I thought was really cool. So if you're here, you don't actually have to go back to the community. You don't have to click a link or anything. I've added this link to go back to that post, but it's just tagged right here. So you could actually click here and open up that thread here and actually comment on it right here. So what I was saying before, I just put some questions like, how did you stumble upon this? Your niche, what are your big dreams, projects, all that sort of stuff like that, which I thought that was really cool. A lot of people do this as well, where they have this start here and it just introduces to everything. So for example, leaderboards, which I'm going to go into in a minute. Basically, when you comment in the community, the more people that like your posts and your comments and stuff like that, the things you can unlock, which I'll get into when I get to the leaderboard here. But basically, a lot of the community is built around the more likes you get, the more value you give in the community, the more rewards the community will normally give you in most communities that you're in. And then that, then school also has an app for Android and Apple or whatever. So yeah, basically stuff like that. I have this thing where not sure, ask here, this might annoy you. So one annoying thing about school sometimes is if you're in multiple groups, you get quite a lot of notifications and stuff like that. So you can actually go and turn the notifications off. So every time someone likes your post, you can turn it off so you don't get notified. Because you think if you did a really good post in this community here and 100 people liked it, that's going to be 100 notifications. So you can actually go turn that off because that will annoy most people, sort of thing. And then like roadmap, meet my team, stuff like that. So normally when you enter a lot of groups, I'll have this little classroom where it sort of explains how the group works and stuff. And then I've got other ones like, if you're just starting an agency, start here. If you want to scale your agency, start here. So for example, I go through stuff like how to jump on a sales call, all different stuff like that. Then I have some other things where free coaching, free premium. So if they unlock certain things, if they get to a certain level. So if we go here to the leaderboard, see how it's got all different levels here. So at level 2, they can chat with members. This is a really good feature because sometimes there's bots and stuff like that. So if someone has to get to level 2 to be able to chat to members, it actually protects your members from getting spam and stuff like that. So someone actually has to go do a post, so introduce themselves, for example, get 5 likes before they can actually chat to members. So that reduces quite a lot of spam. If you think about like a Facebook group, if someone goes to a Facebook group, basically if they get entered in, they can spam your whole thing, sort of thing. So that's a really good feature. And then see how like it says level 3 free coaching call. So if someone gets to level 3, they get a free coaching call with me. If they get to level 7, they get my paid course for free. And then it sort of tells you what level you're at, how many points to go to level. So normally I think it starts at 5 points to get to level 2, then it's like 10 to level 3, then it slightly keeps going up the more, it's like called gamification. So basically the higher the level, the more points to get to the next level. And basically we're going to add lots of other stuff that unlocks at different levels. And we also have something where at the end of every 30 days, whoever's the leader on the leaderboard here, they get a special prize as well, which is pretty cool. So back to the classroom. So yeah, you can basically, I've got heaps of random stuff here, but you can basically go new course, the name, so test, and then the description, test group, course, classroom, like that. And then you can sort of say, is it open to everyone? Does it unlock at a certain level? So if you click here, yeah, you can select what level it unlocks. So for example, let's just say level 5, they could buy it. So you can actually put like a purchase price for this. So if you want to have like free content and then someone to purchase a classroom, you can do that too. A time unlock. So basically they don't get access for 30 days or 20 days or 10 days or something like that. This really encourages people that are in paid groups, which I'll talk about in a minute. Sometimes there's free and paid groups. But this really encourages people to stay in the paid group because things are going to unlock after a certain amount of time. So it's like a reward for staying in the group for longer periods of time. And then there's a private one where you have to give them access to the classroom. Now, this is really good for like gifts and stuff. So let's just say they get some reward and there's a special private classroom that you can only get access to if you win the award. So for example, in my group, I have the top of the leaderboard after 30 days, they get a prize. So they get a call with me and then we're building out a private classroom. So they get access to that also. So that's a little cool thing. And you can upload an image here as well. So you can do that. And then basically you just have to do it at 1460, 75 pixels. I have someone really cool that does thumbnails. I might leave a link to their profile down below. And then basically publish or not publish. So if you want to hide it and have it hidden, which I have a lot of mine hidden, or you can publish it. So if you press add now, there's actually a classroom where we can add like folders and stuff. So if you click these dots, add a folder, we can be like test folder, for example, and then press add. And then we can add pages to that test folder. So we could add page in folder. then edit it up here and be like test page one. And then you can like put text and stuff in here. You can add YouTube videos or Loom videos or links to resources and stuff. So you can add a link, test link. And then let's just say the URL is school.com and then add. Whoa. Having hiccups here. See, that worked now. You got to do the HTML. So see how there's a link here? You can add heaps of different things here. You can add a YouTube video. So there's a button here for like videos. So you can add YouTube, Loom, all that sort of stuff. What I might do here is on this other page, I might just quickly bring up one of my YouTube videos here and just paste it in for you. So here we are. See how my YouTube video is now here, and you can actually play it. Well, I have to save first and then I'll be able to play it. So see how I just played my YouTube video, and you can change the title to test YouTube video if you wanted to. YouTube video like that, and then press save. And then if we go back to the leaderboard here, so if we go back to leaderboard, oh, whoops, classroom. What I'm going to make it. So if we go edit course, I'm going to level and then level 5, then save. Now, if we go back to leaderboard, see how at level 5, the test classroom unlocks at level 5. So that's pretty cool. And then if you want to hide it, you just click these dots, click course, and then hidden right there. One new cool feature that school just added as well is you can drag these now. Before, it used to be super annoying to move one of these, and then see how I could drag it right to the top, or I could drag it here if I wanted to. I could drag it wherever. The one really cool thing about school as well is that in the school community, so they've got a community just about school and stuff. If you have any questions or anything you don't like about school, you can actually write a post. And a lot of the times they take this feedback into consideration. So that was a really annoying thing that was annoying people, and then they ended up changing it. So that's really cool that you can actually have input into the actual how it all works and stuff like that. Now there's another thing here called calendar. So basically you can have weekly calls, monthly calls, all different stuff like that. So I had some calls here. So if you click and open them, I had to cancel that one. So basically this link to like a YouTube live that I did, so they could actually come here and go straight to YouTube live. And then if we go back here, there's another one here. Oh, sorry, I actually went and canceled all of them. That's why they're not all there. But basically you can add a Zoom link to have a calendar. So see how I just clicked that plus, and we can do like weekly call. And then we can put the date and time and stuff like that. Let's just say it starts at 4 p.m. duration, 1 hour. This is my local time. But what will happen if they're in a different time zone, it will actually change it to their time zone. So that's really cool too. Might just do it a little bit later just so it will work. And then you can drop your Zoom link here and then have a description like that. And then you can add a cover photo as well. And you can remind people as well down here 1 day before. And you can also do it that it unlocks at certain levels. So member at level 3. So for example, if you want people to interact in your group and you want to reward them with the weekly calls or monthly calls or whatever, you can actually select it. So at a certain level, it unlocks at that level. And then basically you can do it members in course. So if they're in a certain course and stuff, it unlocks this too. We're going to put it all members. We're going to unselect this and press add. And then it's going to be there. So see how it says 9 p.m. weekly call. There's no link, but if I dropped my Zoom link here and added a photo here, it'll all be here. And they can actually add it straight to their calendar. So any type of calendars they have here, Google, Apple, all that sort of stuff. which I think is really cool that they did that. And then if you want to delete it, you just edit and delete it here. This is actually my favorite feature, or one of my favorite features on School, because if you think about this, I've spent, I don't know, like $50,000 on online courses or something like that. If you think about it, a lot of the courses that you do, you can't really interact with the owner or people in the group or anything like that. It's just like you go in, watch the videos, take action and stuff. At least in School, you can actually jump on weekly calls or monthly calls and ask the owner or their staff on tips and suggestions. Because even though you watch videos, people's situations can be different, or maybe you just need to talk through one little point or something like that. So I really like that. There's also a members tab, so you can see all the different members and stuff. And then back to the leaderboard, like I was talking to about it before, it's basically all built around the levels, going up levels and stuff like that. These days, quite a lot of school groups have different things unlocked at different levels, because one thing I've learned from just listening to other people and stuff like that is if you can get someone to make it to level 5, they're basically going to stay forever. So that's why the gamification on, like, it's easy to get level 2, 3, and then it gets harder and harder, because most people at level 5, when you get them, they're basically going to stay forever, which is really cool, because they like the group, all that sort of stuff. So if you can encourage people to interact with your group, it's really good too. The one really cool thing about people interacting with your group, so basically it's like this flywheel thing. So when you have hardly any members, there's not really going to be a lot of people interacting, but the more members you get, the more people that are engaged, the better the community gets, sort of thing. I was actually in one of Sam Oven's courses back years ago, and one of the things that really helped me was doing practice sales calls. So he used to have a Facebook group, the guy who founded School. He used to have this big Facebook group, and basically you could actually go into the Facebook group and ask people to practice sales calls. So I actually got on a sales call with a couple of random people from the group, and still to this day, one of the practice calls I got on was actually the hardest sales call I've ever done, and I've done over 1,000 now. So it's really cool how you can do different things like that and not have the distraction of Facebook. And then this tab here is the about. So you're probably only going to ever see this once when you go into a group, because they'll have like a video, maybe they'll have some photos and stuff here of reviews and things like that. It will have like who started the group, how many members and stuff like that. At the moment, we have 243. And then it's got a bit about the group. So for example, my clients have made over $100 million, won awards, got reviews, all different things like that. And then over here, it's got a little bit about me, and then the members online, how many staff, like admin is like staff and stuff like that. And then if you're not part of the group, it'll say join here and you can join. It'll either be free or paid, which I'll get into in a minute. So if we actually click into settings here, it has all different stuff here. So it has like a dashboard. This is a free community, by the way, so it hasn't earned any money or anything like that. And then it's got payouts. So it'll tell you like if your group has had payouts, it'll tell you how much here, and then you can actually press a button to transfer them to your bank, basically. You can invite people with this link here. Just general stuff like profile picture, your banner picture, the name of the group, a little description, the initials, the color scheme, if it's a private group or a public group, stuff like that. You can actually have a custom URL as well. So I actually picked Inspire because my other business is built around Inspire, and I wanted to build this around this group around Inspire. I actually read a book, Your One Word, that actually, it talks a lot about building a business around one word that you really resonate with, and Inspire resonates with me. Subscription, so at the moment free, we have 243 people on free, but you can actually make it a paid group by adding a price. So for example, if you wanted to do a $5 group, you could here. So now we could actually change this. See how it says current price, $5. They need to pay $5 a month to join this group. It can be anything as well. So for example, we can make it current, and then we can delete this or do a new price. So I think the max you can do is $999 a month. Yep, pretty sure that is the most. Let me just change this back here. I'll delete this. And you might be thinking $999 a month is a lot. It is $999 USD a month. It is a lot, but I've actually paid people that to like a monthly fee. But normally a lot of the times when people are charging $999 USD a month, there's some sort of service behind it as well. Categories. So basically in your community, these are the different categories people can post under. So like general, you can actually add categories here too. So we could add a test and then test, then add. So people, when they do a post, they can actually put it into test. So see how general discussion, there's 116 posts. Wins, 29. Introduce yourself, 30. So originally, when I started this group, I had people do unique posts for introducing themselves. And then I decided to put it all into one, so it just doesn't clutter up the community. And then updates, story time, stuff like that. And then basically, if I went back to the community here and then did a post like test, I could change the category to test right there, and it would go into the category as well. Let me just go back here. Categories, and then you can come here and delete the category also like that. Tabs, so you can turn the classroom and the calendar off. So if you don't want to have any classroom, you can turn that tab off and it'll disappear up here, which it just did. And if you don't want to have any weekly calls, you can turn off that also. So I think this was actually a feature someone suggested in the school community, because some school communities, they never have the calls or they never have the classroom. So it makes sense just to turn that tab off instead of having it blank. And then there's all these different plugins that they keep adding. So membership questions. So basically, if someone wants to enter my community, there's some questions that they have to answer. So add their email. How did you find it? Which is multiple choice. So they're the different choices they can select. And then what type of agency and where are they located as well. So that's really cool. It just sort of filters out spam and stuff like that. So if someone doesn't answer the questions right, you just don't let them into your group. And if you noticed here, back in the community here, see how it says membership request pending. So four people are trying to get access into the community and I haven't approved them yet. So that's basically what that does. All different like Zapier integrations, webhooks, auto DM. So they actually get you can automatically send them a message when they enter the group. So mine is like, hi, their name, welcome to my group. I made a quick video on how this group works so they can watch this Loom video. And don't forget to introduce yourself. So that goes to the introduce post. And then if you aren't sure about anything, just ask. So they can actually message straight to me if they have any questions. Unlock chat at level 2, so you can turn that on and off, which I was talking about before in the leaderboard. So unlocking chat at level 2 just removes some of the spam and stuff like that. You can do it for posting also, so they're not allowed to post until they're level 2. I might actually just turn that on while we're here. So let's turn that on. So they can't post spam and stuff like that. You can hook up your Metapixel for Facebook ads and stuff like that here. And instant membership approval. So if you want people to be approved instantly, you can turn this on. I don't want to do that because I don't want to let like a lot of spam and stuff into the group. I want it to be really cool. And then it has this metrics of like total members, active members, all this stuff like this. And then gamification, which I was talking about before with the leaderboard, you can actually change the names of the levels. So I actually changed it to level 1 noob, contributor, inspired, all-rounder, inspirational, grandmaster. I like chess, going pro, legend, goat sort of thing. So I changed some of the names to that. For example, you can have whatever you want. In my other group, I put one as like Shopify expert, for example. So yeah, you can make it unique for your group. So for example, if you talked about magic, for example, I'm just thinking of Harry Potter for some reason, you could actually have it as wizard names or different things like that. Then this other one tells you where you rank on discovery. So my group is ranking number 7,785. I think it's like one of the highest ones for Shopify as well. It might be on the first page, because you can actually rank on the school community as well. And then links, so you can have different links to different stuff. So for example, one-on-one coaching call, create a school group, my YouTube channel, and then the billing down here. So where those links are is right here. So there's heaps of different things you can do on the platform as well. You can also go to your profile here. This is my profile, and it sort of says my two groups here, how active I've been, a little intro about me, personality test. So if you've ever done Myers-Briggs test, you can actually put it here. And then if I just go, if I just remove this, for example, it will tell me I joined school 4 years ago. I'm from Sydney. That's how many posts I've done. That's how many followers I got. That's how many people I follow. You can add all your social media here, down there, and powered by school. So someone can go straight to your YouTube channel, all different things like that. These are some cool groups that I'm in. So LinkedIn Bootcamp with Vendy, that's pretty cool. That's a monthly fee. School Masterclass, which talks about school and stuff, and then Organic SEO Growth. So there's some groups I'm in, and these are the groups I also have as well. And you can click here and view them. How you would actually change that is you click this little icon, go settings, and all your different settings are here, and you can change your location. There's all different stuff here. If you don't want people to message you, you can actually turn that off. So see, if I go chat here, I can turn notifications off, all different stuff like that. So if I don't want anyone to message me, turn chat off, all different communities, payment methods, themes. So you can go light mode as well. So this will change it to a light background school. So if you like light better, you can do that. Or if you like dark, you can do that as well. So that's heaps of different things that you can do on school. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you're using school, don't forget, if you use my affiliate link and send me a message, I'll send over a free gift as well. But yeah, hopefully that gives you a good rundown of how school works, because I really think this is really powerful, this community. It sort of reminds me of like how TikTok exploded a few years ago. I really think school is just on the brink of just exploding. It's exploded a lot over the last 6 months, and I think it's going to continue, especially now they have this thing called school games, which I forgot to say. Basically, the top 10 people each month with recurring revenue can actually go to meet Sam Ovens, Alex Amosi at acquisition.com. So at the end of each month, whoever's got the most monthly revenue can actually fly out and meet them, which is pretty cool as well. This is actually the school games community, by the way, so you can actually join this community, and it talks all about that also. And if you're wondering what this cat is, it actually plays music and stuff. So there's like little hacks and stuff where if you press certain different buttons in the back end of school and stuff like that, it unlocks cool little features and things like that. And then basically one thing quickly, that calendar that I was talking about, it actually tells you how far away the calendar is if you have one there. So see how it says Hormozy Q&A is happening in 38 hours. So you can actually click here and then go through to that link as well, which is really cool. But yeah, like, let me know what you think in the comments. Do you want me to make other videos telling you how to do little different things in school as well? I'd love to know, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.